Florida. It was published in 1936. It was written for alto saxophone for Marcel Mule, who was a very important figure in early classical saxophone. Aria is a term for an opera, so it's like a lyrical, vocal, very expressive song. And Johannes and I played it at Solon Ensemble like 3 or 4 years ago. So.
Testing off an old one.
Yeah, the other one we played last this year. So.
More.
So this performance is, of course, celebrating Lena, celebrating Lena's friends who have played music with her throughout these years. But it's also a performance by Lena in honor and for her teachers, two of whom are here, David Leach and Bobby Strang. Where's Bobby? There,
back
there.
Others, we were thinking back to a recent 4th of July, we were coming back from the fireworks in Burns Park, and we were pulling around towards our house and wound up on the corner where the Blank Slate Creamery is, you know, where everybody always congregates, and there was music, so we decided, oh, that sounds great, and we just stopped. And it turns out that Ben Jansen, who was Lena's first saxophone teacher in Ann Arbor, back from Japan, together with Paul Finkbeiner, who's well known around town as a trumpeter, who was our son's teacher, with a pianist and a percussionist who I don't recall, just making music on the sidewalk. And it was such a great example of what Ann Arbor is all about, that you find music on the sidewalks, in the schools, certainly at the university, the back and forth between the university and the schools and the sidewalks and the public spaces. And of course, this house, which there's a German term that I was thinking of this afternoon. It's for when you gather people and invite them over to your house for music, it's called Hauskonzert. Makes sense. So this seems really apt that we're having the concert house for a Hauskonzert.
Right. Because our piano at home, that was always one of the big troubles of the two of them playing, we brought that piano with us from Germany to Ann Arbor, but it is too low.
It's tuned to about 432. So it's very hard, as the kids know who are practicing this afternoon, it's very hard to get saxophones.
So you guys should have played more often. So Ben Jansen recommended, when he left for Japan, he recommended Bobby that Lena should take lessons with Bobby.
Yeah.
And that was amazing. That was 5 years ago. And Bobby has accompanied Lena, you know, through high school, through all of her programs, and Johannes will say a bit more about the programs that Lena participated in. And I mean, we all know Ann Arbor is a great music town, and we all love Ann Arbor for it, but Ann Arbor wouldn't be such a music town without the teachers, who are really the backbone of the music programs at the public schools, which are amazing, of the music program at the university. Of course, we then have the high-end, the University Musical Society, but everything...
Or the trio with Ellen Rowe, which warmed up for us. I don't know if you...
They played today here, you know, and more. And tonight, it's us. It's Lena.
But this is also a shout-out to Carolyn Bybee, who's not here, but who was a teacher for some of these kids. Right, Amelia?
And Alicia,
right? And Saki. All right, so Carolyn Bybee, who's still teaching at the Ann Arbor Open School. We should mention Keaton Simpson, who's Lena's first piano teacher. I was also thinking this afternoon, this music making has been amazing in the house. And it's, of course, accompanied with a lot of, have you practiced your instrument? You need to practice your instrument. She's rolling her eyes right now. And I think we were pretty pushy sometimes. And then at some point, I think we realized when Lena started doing the jazz program over at Community with Jack, and dual enrolling and doing, it was varsity, I think, varsity band, and concert band, and then symphony band over at...
Pioneer,
and then switching from jazz over Community to jazz band at Pioneer, and then going to Bobby's lessons on Wednesdays, I realized that on Wednesdays, Lena is practicing her instrument 3 hours, and she's practicing every day for at least two, so we kind of stopped working. it's really incredible. I mean,
but I also have to say, you know, that whenever she would come back on Wednesday evening or afternoon from Bobby, And I, you know, we would ask her, so how was it? And she said, it was fun.
Sometimes
they would even forget the time because
they were playing duets.
So, I mean, amazing. And then David Leach, is the director of an award-winning music program at Pioneer High School, and Lena played for 3 years in the band program, for 4 years in the band program, right? And then last year, also in the jazz band with David Leach. And
they've played in some pretty cool places.
They played in cool places. They played a concert at Carnegie Hall 3 years ago. And this year, they traveled through Italy and Croatia. And played, Lena in 1 week played with the symphony band and the jazz band 5 concerts.
On jet lag.
So that's quite an accomplishment. Thanks to David Leach.
So, yeah, can we get another round? So after they play...
They're not kids anymore.
Okay. The cool kids. So after they play, we've got some snacks, so please stay and mingle. This is as much about socializing as about music, but right now it's about music. So Lena will be playing with friends, and she'll, I suppose, say your own thanks, but I want to say thanks, or we want to say thanks, even just for practicing at our house this afternoon. It was amazing to listen to them figure out how to end the charts that they're going to play, which charts they're going to play, but also how to divide the parts and what maybe to do. And the combined musical intelligence in that room was phenomenal. I was just lying on the couch listening, but I loved listening to you guys practice and just come up with, bounce ideas off each other and change something on the spur and then see if it worked. And usually, always, it was for the better. So I'm excited to hear what you came up with. So we've got Rishi, Sam, Mei, and Lena playing for starters, and then there'll be some special guests introduced later.
And so Rishi, Lena played with Rishi at Community High in the jazz combo, and then Sam and Lena played together this year in Pioneer High School's jazz band, and then Sam also plays at Community High, the jazz combo, Mei. And Lena started their musical career together at an ABBA Open with Miss Ivy. And now Mei is also a star in the jazz program at Community High, playing together in a combo with Sam. So these four, and then we have Lydia. Lydia is the star of the Pioneer Jazz Band. She is the singer of the Pioneer Jazz Band, and she will also sing 2 songs for us.
Thanks again for being here.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is In a Sentimental Mood by Dugalica. Should I do A?
Thank you. I like the day.
Thank you.
doesn't really should worry about it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Another annual house concert in Ann Arbor, which is the musicale. We also forgot to mention Water Hill, which just happened last weekend, which is phenomenal, where I saw a lot of you. But we've been playing together at the musicale, I don't know.
10 years.
Probably 10 years. We're now members of the Ryan Valley Rockers, as his dog.
Again?
Are we gonna help so? Yeah, we gotta figure it out for this year. Maybe with more than one rehearsal. So anyway, that's where this comes from.
Thanks to Lou and Donna.
Yeah, to Lou and Donna, who couldn't be here because they're in Ireland or something like that. Are you gonna announce it?
I can announce it.
Okay, it's called When Sunny Gets Blue.